Alright, so we are back with the last E3 roundup of this year, so let's get right into it.
Let me just get this out of the way right here and now. Nintendo won E3 by a mile, without question.
Like seriously, this has been the most mid E3 I've ever experienced. Nintendo easily carried it, their backs must be hurting. Right at the fucking start, they announced the new Smash DLC character. And it's none other than Kazuya from fucking Tekken. At first I thought it was a new trailer for Breath of the Wild 2. But as soon as I saw that cliff and how Ganondorf was being thrown off, I instantly knew it was Tekken. Not gonna lie, I was still hoping Crash would get in. But Kazuya is still a good pick and we need more fighting game reps in here. But it wasn't Ganondorf who got thrown off, it was fucking Captain Falcon, Min Min, Kid Icarus, even fucking Kirby, but he still managed to survive. Thank fuck. Kazuya still got his devil form with him. And Sakurai's gonna do his demonstration of him on the 28th, so I'll definitely be tuning into that.
I swear, if they announced Crash Bandicoot as a Mii costume during that event, I'm gonna be so mad.
I'm gonna skip all in the mid shit because I need to talk about this one. This one has me fucking hyped. They showed off the leaked Super Monkey Ball Mania and it looks fucking incredible. Not only is it gonna be on Switch, but it's gonna be on PS4 and Xbox One and PS5 and Xbox Series X. It's even gonna be on Steam.
Thank you!
The game is basically a remake of Monkey Ball 1 and 2 and even Deluxe.
It's coming out October 5th and you already know it's gonna be copped.
Especially the Digital Deluxe Edition. Not only do you get the original game, but you get 6 classic character skins, 3 legendary console skins, 10 customizable items, and the OG soundtrack from the original Monkey Ball games. But yeah, Banana Mania is coming out October 5th. I am hyped, I can't fucking wait for this game, let's go. Next they showed off a new Mario Party called Mario Party Superstars. This one basically has every board from every single Mario Party. I haven't really played much Mario Party, but this looks really cool.
And this was when Nintendo started balling in this direct.
They announced a new Metroid game, and it's a new 2D Metroid called Metroid Dread. And I've only just found out recently that it's been in development since 2005, my god. But yeah, it looks fucking lit. I've only just started getting back into Metroid. Metroid Zero Mission recently became one of my favorite games of all time.
It'll be coming out October 10th, and I don't even have a Switch, but if I did, I would definitely cop it. Like, it looks really fucking lit.
And after that, they said these familiar franchises are coming back on Nintendo Switch, and I was like, Jesus Christ, Nintendo, chill. Are you gonna bring back F-Zero?
And as soon as they said that, they started showing Just Dance 2022.
Oh, for fuck's sake. But yeah, we've already talked about that in the Ubisoft E3 roundup, so not much to say there. Then they showed off another game that looked insane. It's called Cruisin' Blast. It was originally on arcades. Fortunately, it's only coming out on Switch, so... Alright, on to the next game, and this one is another port. They're finally porting Dragon Ball Z Kakarot into Nintendo Switch. That game only came out a year and a half ago, but better late than never. I still haven't played Kakarot, but the game itself looks really cool. If I decide to cop it on Xbox One, then I could do a stream of it if you all want to see that. Not gonna lie, the graphics look kind of off, but this is on Switch, so I'm not really that surprised. Next was Mario Golf Super Rush. Again, it looks cool. I'm not really that into Mario Golf. They ran a lot of content to this game, though. Of course, you got your standard golf, but then you also got your speed golf, your battle golf, and your golf adventure. Bro, it's fucking golf. But yeah, the game looks cool. They're even adding more updates to it. Alright, we're skipping this next one because I don't really give a fuck about Monster Hunter. And also, it's Wario time.
Oh man, that was actually cringe. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, they announced a new WarioWare game called WarioWare Get It Together. This looks like it's going to be the biggest WarioWare game yet. It also has two-player co-op, which is really cool. Of course, Nintendo couldn't help themselves and showed off a lot of anime RPGs. They showed off Doom Eternal's first DLC, which is only now coming on Switch. And then they started advertising the Switch port of Tony Hawk 1 and 2. And they still called it a fucking remaster when it's a remake. It's 2021 and companies are still doing this shit. But yeah, I've already played Tony Hawk 1 and 2 on Xbox One. And it's an amazing remake. It recently just came out on PS5 and Xbox Series X 2 months ago, and it's going to be coming out on Switch on the 25th of this month, so obviously being on the Switch, it's going to be running that 30 FPS, but if you don't give a fuck about frame rates, then you can cop it on there. Mario and Rabbids, again, we already talked about that in the Ubisoft video, so not much to say there. Alright, moving back to the big stuff, this is their last set of announcements, and all of these will be about Zelda, so strap yourselves in. They talked about a new expansion for Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity, and then they showed off Skyward Sword HD again. But then they announced the new Legend of Zelda Game & Watch system. It basically just has Zelda 1, 2, and a Game & Watch style game in there. They even added the playable clock and the playable timer, which is really cool. And unlike the Mario Game & Watch system, you can actually purchase this whenever you want. Yes, none of that limited release bullshit this time. This system will be there forever. And last but not least, after 2 years, they finally showed gameplay for the sequel to The Breath of the Wild. They showed gameplay and it's coming out in 2022, which basically proves everything I've been saying about this certain franchise. But don't worry, that'll be another video for another day. And yeah, that basically wraps up the Nintendo Direct for E3 2021. Like I said earlier, Nintendo won E3 without even breathing. If I were to rank all of these E3 events for this year, it would be Nintendo at the very top, Microsoft and Bethesda second, Ubisoft third, PC Gaming Show 4th, Capcom 5th, and at the bottom of the barrel, fucking Bandai Namco, because they only showed one game that was already announced at Summer Games Fest. But yeah, this was a very, very mid E3, but hopefully by next year, when COVID has died down, we can finally get back to some actual conferences. But yeah, let me know what you all think of E3 in general this year. Did you like it? Did you think it was mid? And what did you think of the Nintendo Direct for this year? Did you think Nintendo won E3? Or did you think Microsoft won E3? Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell, all that good stuff. And yeah, we'll be going back to regular content from this point on. I'm BrightX2000BX2. Enjoy the rest of your day and take care. Bless.